4 years after the Yom Kippur War, tensions remained high between Egypt and Israel. President Carter, wanting to bring peace to the Middle East, invited Prime Minister Begin to Washington for their first in-person meeting on July 19, 1977. Prime Minister Begin requested a meeting with the Rebbe before he would meet with Carter. Yehuda Avner served as an advisor and speechwriter to 5 Israeli prime ministers. Yechiel Kadishai was Prime Minister Menachem Begin's lifetime personal secretary. Shlomo Nachdimon, a political correspondent for Yediot Achronot, covered Begin's trip to the U.S.
את הכניסה של מנחם בגין לחצר ואחר כך כבר סיפרו את הסיפור הזה איך ניסה כל אחד שהשני יקדים אותו ואני כבר לא זוכר בדיוק מי ניצח בפעמיים או 3 פעמים של כניסה זה כבר תואר הרבה פעמים המעמד הזה ואני כבר לא זוכר בדיוק מי ניצח בפעם הראשונה ומי בפעם השנייה כל אחד רצה שהשני יקדים אותו, נתן לו את הכבוד.
I have come tonight to our great master and teacher, the rabbi, to ask and get from him his blessings before I go to Washington to meet President Carter for the important talks we are going to hold on the future of the Middle East. The people in Israel do pray for the success of those very important meetings. I do not call them faithful meetings because the people of Israel, the Jewish people, are an eternal people and their lot and future are not dependent on a political meeting. With the leader of the free world. However, such a meeting has great importance for our future. And therefore, I have asked for the blessings of the rabbi, of our great teacher. Rabbi Schneerson is a great man in Israel. All of us respect him. All of us accept his judgment. He is a great lover of the house of Israel. He has shown his deep sentiment and love for our children. His blessings are very important to me. I do hope they will strengthen me on that very important mission I am going to fulfill during the meetings with President Carter, the President of the United States.
Would the rabbi care to say something?
My main pronouncement was in the language of the Jews of Russia from whom I come. But I only add a few words to recapitulate my blessings for the great success of this very important mission of the Premier Minister and also to underline a second time that I accept this honor of his visit, certainly not on my personal account, but on account of the movement of Lubavitch, who was dedicated for centuries to permeate the Jewish people everywhere with a firm faith in God Almighty and firm faith in their faith that they'll have all their wishes for good fulfilled, and in holding on to our tradition of Torah, and mitzvahs to go from strength to strength in spreading kindness and goodness around us, and that will be also a good vessel to accept the blessings of God Almighty in all their needs in the diaspora and in the Holy Land, and to have real peace as a preparation for the coming of Messiah speedily in our time. And a special thanks to the Prime Minister, and also through him to the Jews in Eretz Yisrael, in our Holy Land in general.
So you are giving Mr. Begin your blessings, as he asked?
Yeah, more than 100%.
After extending greetings to members of Begin's delegation and journalists, Begin and the Rebbe were left to speak alone.
המעניין הוא מה היה בשיחה שלהם שנמשכה שעה וחצי ואין על זה תיעוד. מה שאנחנו ראינו העיתונאים מבחוץ, דרך החלון והצללים של האורות, את הרבי עם המקבעת המפורסמת שלו ואת מנחם בגין עם כיפתו הגדולה, והראשים התנועו ככה והתנועו ככה. אף אחד לא ניסה לקרוא את השפתיים. לא נכתב שום דבר מבחינת תיעוד, הם היו בארבע עיניים. המערכת של חב"ד לא צילמה את הפגישה הזו, לא הקליטה את השיחה הזו, אז לדעתי זה אובדן קשה להיסטוריה, אבל אין ספק שזו הייתה שיחה מאוד מעמיקה לגבי הנושא של שלמות הארץ, הן מבחינת ההלכה, הן מבחינת הפוליטיקה הריאלית, ואין מבחינת האפשרויות שאפשר להסיק.
כאשר יצאו, כל אחד מהעיתונאים רצה לדעת על מה דיברו. אז אני זוכר שבגין אמר, מה שדיברנו ביחידות, דיברנו ביחידות. כן? ליחידות. ולא גילה דברים שדור בהם בפנים. ועד היום אני לא יודע מה בדיוק דיברו.
Whatever I say to the rabbi and he says to me is between us. There is an old custom between us for many, many years. It's not my first meeting with Rabbi Schneerson. We met many, many times when I still served my people in opposition, but the more so when I am prime minister. Every conversation with the rabbi is completely confidential, so he will not ask me on television, on the radio, intimately to tell you what we talked about.
It lasted until after midnight with this turnout in Brooklyn, the culmination of a long day of meetings with American Jewish leaders who gave Prime Minister Begin a last-minute demonstration of support before his meeting with President Carter. Begin was very moved by the reception. This large and emotional demonstration of American Jewish support will no doubt send Begin to Washington feeling much more secure in his position for his talks with President Carter. Bill Siemens, ABC News, Brooklyn.
At Begin's request, Yehuda Avner returned to New York a few days later to report on the talks with President Carter.
I was ushered straight into the Rebbe. And I gave him a report of the meeting. I'm not permitted on camera to go into details because there's still segments of that meeting that are classified. I must have spoken for half an hour. I had notes nonstop. And then the Rebbe began to comment. When I came out, the hall was packed with people waiting to come in. People had come from all over the world for Yechidus. And there was Rav Kleiner, Rav Groner, and I must have been in a haze. It was a mix of both the fatigue and the encounter and the experience and this imagery and this sense of love that he communicated. I've never met a man in my life we use the term common touch. A person has a common touch. This was beyond a common touch. This was a person who made every individual feel he or she really mattered. And the depth of his grasp of our geopolitical strategic situation. His sources were numerous and were extraordinary. I say much of it, to this day, I cannot talk about because it's classified. So with this impact, when I came out, so I said, Rav Groner, I said to him, that man should be the Prime Minister of Israel. And I remember Rav Groner nodding as if to say how right you are. And then he escorted me to the door. There was a car waiting for me. I said, I'm going to suggest to Prime Minister Begin he set up a hotline with the Rebbe.